Numbers, the 12th chapter, verses 1 through 5. My own Elder Curtis is going to read it for us on today. Numbers, the 12th chapter. Verses 1 through the 5th verse. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
And it reads, and Miriam and Aaron spoke against Moses because of the Ethiopian woman whom he had married. But he had married an Ethiopian woman. And they said, had the Lord indeed spoken only by Moses? Had he not spoken also by us? And the Lord heard it. Now the man Moses was very meek above all the men which were upon the face of the earth. And the Lord spoke suddenly unto Moses and unto Aaron and unto Miriam, come out, ye three, unto the tabernacle of the congregation. And they three came out. Verse 5, and it reads, and the Lord came down in the pillar of the cloud and stood in the door of the tabernacle and called Aaron and Miriam, and they both came forth.
Amen. I'm going to use for subject on today, babe, for major topic. Beware of your word in God's presence.
Amen.
It's amazing how we sit in the church, tongue talking, foot stomping, hand clapping, and yet we sit there and talk about one another back in the church. And God hear every word you say. It's amazing if the pastor says something you don't like, you tell your friend, call me later and I explain it to you. Amen. If they're in your clique. Amen. There's certain people in your clique, amen, that agree with everything you said. Amen, amen. Then you said, don't worry about it. Just leave it alone and pray. Amen. Amen. Beware of the words that you say in the church. Because God can hear you.
Yes.
I ain't going to ask you to put your hand. How many in here, I said something, you got mad, amen, amen, and went and called your friend and your buddy, amen, amen. I'm just praying for the pastor. I didn't like what he said, but, you know, I'm not mad. I'm just pray for me. Amen. How many of you ever got mad at the pastor or your leader in your church? Don't put your hand up because I know some of y'all did. Hello, somebody. Say amen, amen. Moses, amen. Miriam and Aaron. Now, Miriam, Moses' sister. Now, amen, amen, amen. Flesh and blood, amen. Talking against Moses because he has truly want to marry somebody else. Ethiopian women, amen, amen, amen. If that's not a racial slur, I don't know what it is. Lord, I wish I had somebody talk back to me. Amen. Y'all might be quiet.
Yes.
Amen, amen. Some of you have said words in the chat about your leader, but you don't want nobody to know what you said. It's quiet.
That's all right.
Amen. 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 And some of you, amen, talk about people right in their presence. And you be saying, here they come. Don't talk now because they're coming. Hello, somebody. Say amen. I know it's not a shouting message. I ain't a preacher shouting to make this morning. Amen. Because some of you know exactly what you said. The words that come out your mouth sometimes can be a damage to somebody else.
Amen.
Because you don't know what to say out of your mouth. Amen. Some of you are looking at me right now. Amen. Amen. Some of you are looking at me right now. Don't you like the topic? That's what I said.
Amen.
Say amen. I didn't come to please you, but I came to please God.
Amen.
Hello, somebody. Because some of you have sit in the chat, talk about salvation and deliverance, and you're a member of salvation and deliverance.
Amen.
And you act like nothing going on.
Amen.
Be careful of the word that you say. Hello, somebody. Say amen. Say amen. Because the word that you say can be damaging to someone else.
Amen.
Hello, somebody. Amen. Amen. You don't have to be a rocket scientist, amen, to know the word. Amen. All you got to do is just study it.
Amen.
Amen. And God will reveal himself unto you. Don't think you can, just because you know the word, you better than somebody else. Amen. I got news for you. Amen. If the anointing is not in your life, amen, it doesn't mean a nickel or bean. You got to be anointed when you carry the word. I don't care how much you quote the scripture. We got too many deep folks in the church, but we don't have no humble people in the body of Christ. Everybody got a prophecy. I'm just saying that people got a prophecy. Soon as you pray, the Lord told me to tell you. The Lord told me to tell you. The Lord told me to tell you. Amen. If the Lord is telling you so much, why don't he tell you pay your tithes on time?
Get out of here.
Because the words that you say, I don't need no man to tell me nothing.
Get out of here.
I'm obeying God. Say amen. Moses was a meek man.
Yes.
Moses wasn't an eloquent speaker like some of you sitting in the pews. But Moses had help.
Yes.
Moses was raised by the enemy.
Yes.
Pharaoh's daughter found in the bank of the river. In the basket, amen. But you know one thing about the basket had to be waterproof. If it wasn't, Moses would have sank.
Amen.
Tell somebody.
Amen.
Amen. They raised Moses for a little while until Moses got grown enough to take his journey, what the Lord called him to do.
Come on, Apostle.
But Moses had to face a task of his life by the name of a man by the name of Pharaoh.
Yes.
Yes.
And Pharaoh was just like some of the people in the body of Christ.
Yes.
Stiff-necked, hard-headed, and stubborn until God gets hold of you. Tell somebody, amen. One thing about the Lord know how to break you. He know how to mold you. He know how to shape you. And he know how to break you down.
Yes.
Tell somebody, say amen. Say amen. Amen. How many of you ever told a lie on the Lord? The Lord told me to tell you, you have to come be with me. That's a lie. Lord, I wish I had somebody, amen. Because all we want to do is get you to be in their presence. Amen. I'd rather be in the presence of some anointed folks instead of being in the presence of some gossip folks. Lord, I wish I had somebody. I thought it was going to be a shout message this morning. Be careful of the word that you say in God's presence. Now, remember when Aaron was talking about Moses in the presence of the Lord. He said, y'all three come out. Come on. Come on. Come on. I got something to tell you. Come on. Come on out, out of the camp. Come on. And in the pillar of a cloud, amen. Come on, I want to tell you something. You're talking about Moses, my man servant, amen, the prophet of God. You sit right in the presence of the Lord, talking about Mary. You know that is your brother. What your brother has done, you don't like Moses, because Moses don't be married an Egyptian woman, a woman you don't like, you don't have no knowledge about him, and you and Aaron got an attitude.
Yes.
Come out, come out.
Amen, amen.
Come on out. I need to speak to all three of you. Come on out. Say amen. Say amen. Mary got struck with leprosy.
Yes,
sir. But open up her mouth. But you notice a minute. Mary got struck with leprosy. But who had to pray for Mary's deliverance?
All right.
The same man that she talked about, Moses. Moses had to go talk to God. And back in them days, when you get leprosy, you had to be outside in isolation from the people. Amen. You got to go set aside like by yourself, like this quarantine here we have now. Amen. Amen. Pandemic 19. They had to isolate you.
Yes.
Well, all right.
And you couldn't get involved with nobody for a certain amount of days.
All
right. Now, it's 7 days. In New York, they got 14 days. Amen, amen, amen. Some of y'all need to isolate yourself now. You talk too much.
Yeah. All right.
Amen. When you in God's presence, you say things you ain't got no business to say.
All right.
Amen, amen. A little babe in Christ don't know the word, but you say things in their presence. Amen. And God is looking at you.
Yeah.
Amen. And Moses was a man. Amen. Amen. God knew that Moses was qualified for the task.
Yeah.
Because he told Moses, and Moses, go and tell Pharaoh to let my people go. Tell somebody, Moses went and tell Pharaoh. Pharaoh looked at Moses, Moses, go back where you belong. You ain't talking to me because I'm the king here. I'm in charge. Amen. In the name of the Lord. So be careful what you say in God's presence. Amen. They were talking in God's presence. Don't let God hear everything. God hear everything we say from the pulpit to the door. Amen. Some of you, the reason why some of you not be, even some of my preachers are looking at me funny. Lord, I wish I had somebody, but you was up here. You want everybody to hoop, holler, run, and jump. Now you're looking at me funny because you don't just start talking about somebody you shouldn't have to say nothing about. Lord, I wish I had somebody. It's time up for we stop talking about people and you don't have the right information. Lord, I wish I had somebody talk back to me. Amen. You open up your mouth, you talk about people. Amen. You don't know what Blige went through to get to where he wants, to get where he at. Amen. Amen. You talk about me, but the more you talk, I'm going to bend my knees because we know that prayer change this thing. In the presence of the Lord, they holiness, amen. We got to be careful when we say we come talking, foot stomping, hand stomping in the presence of the Lord. And we talk about our sisters and brothers in the Christ, amen. And we expect them to go along with it, amen. Be careful what comes out your mouth. Anything that comes out your mouth should be good, nice, and it should be fruitful when a person, amen, is going through, amen. When you're going through, amen, you don't need to have no bad gossip. You need to hear some good words. And in the word of God, I got a hiding place. Be careful in the presence of the Lord. Because you can hurt yourself. You can hurt yourself. And Moses, when he died, he was over 100 years old. The Bible said his eyes was good, he was not dim. He had good eyesight. Amen, amen. Preachers are so busy preaching on one another that some of us, we can't see the devil.
Amen, amen.
Hello somebody, that's another topic, amen, amen. Amen. The devil is sitting right next to you. And you think everybody is your friend. Amen. Your friend ain't gonna like you when you take a stand.
Okay.
Hello somebody. Amen. Especially if you're standing for truth. Lord, I wish I had somebody. Amen. Be careful what proceeds out your mouth. Amen. Be careful what comes out your mouth. Amen. In the presence of the Lord. Amen. You can do much damage to yourself. Amen. Amen. See, Pharaoh wasn't careful what came out of his mouth when he announced all the firstborn should die. Pharaoh did it to himself. Amen. Amen. How many of you ever say something about somebody in the church? Amen. 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 Don't realize when you get home, you say, Lord, I'm sorry. Hey, and the person's right behind you. I heard exactly what you said. Oh, I wasn't just joking. No, you wasn't joking. You tried to brush it off because you already said it. No. Amen. In the presence of the Lord, amen. You got to be careful. Amen. If you don't like somebody, keep your mouth shut. Lord, I wish I had somebody, because in God's presence, God hears everything. God knows everything. He knows the hair on your head. He knows your next move. He knows exactly where you're going when you leave here. He knows exactly what you're going to do. He knows exactly who you're going to call. God knows everything. So you better make up your mind to get yourself lined up with the word. Amen. Amen. Because you know a lot of people not going to be liking you when you say you're going to get right with God. Amen. The minute you decide to get right with God, there's going to be some haters. There's going to be some jealousy. There's going to be some backbiters. There's going to be some folks don't like you. So when you mess up in your mind, for the Lord I live and for God I die, folks gonna call you a holy roller. Call me a holy roller. Because my mind is made up and my heart is fixed. I want to see Jesus. And Moses.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
They take down from Pharaoh.
Oh,
they
did.
Amen. He stood his ground. Amen. And sometimes when you're in the presence of the Lord, you got to be very careful. Especially in the sanctuary. Amen. Because sometimes we be in the sanctuary, we don't be praying, we be gossiping. Help somebody. Say, man, it's a hot message today.
That's all right.
Say, man, we be in the sanctuary, we be sitting. Yeah, but y'all, you know, that's why you see I'm by myself. I'm going to stay by myself because these folks is a mess. Father, I wish I had somebody. Talking about the church folk is a mess and you part of the church, but you a mess yourself. Father, I wish I had somebody. You going to call the church folks a mess and you part of the church and you part of the mess. Father, I wish I had somebody. Talk back there, but yet you sitting there make people think that you're more anointed. Amen. When you get with them, when you get around them, amen. You feel something. You didn't feel nothing before I came around. Why you want to feel it now? Lord, I wish I had somebody. Don't shake and bake around me. Keep still, Lord. Amen. One thing I can't stand, a person get up to me and stop talking about it. I got a word for you. Don't stop shaking. Don't shake around me because I'm going to stop you. I don't want to hear your shake. Amen. You wasn't shaking before I came to you, so why you going to shake now? Because everybody don't have a word. Amen. You got some folks that have a word, but some people don't have a word. Lord, I wish I had somebody talk about that. Everybody said they got a word. They don't have a word. Everybody that got a word for you, amen, and see how quick you move. moving. They are jealous of your position. Lord, I wish I had somebody. We've got too many positions, mine and both, in the church. Amen. They sit right in the church, want your position. Amen. You think they mean you well? They don't mean you well. See, once God equipped you and anointed you and appointed you, you can't nobody take their position. Lord, I wish I had a praying church here. Amen. And see, one thing about the anointing, see, the anointing breaks yoke. The anointing is squad devil. Lord, I wish I had somebody. Lord, I feel like it's talking just a little bit. See, once you're in God's presence, Lord, and you hold up your hand and say, Lord, thank you. And you're kneeling down before God. Something about being in God's presence. Something about being in the anointing. See, once you're in the presence of God, amen, you know when God is not speaking, you want to make sure it's God. You want to make sure that God is talking. Amen. See, God is talking to so many people now. And you got to be careful now. Because the devil is on one side and the God is on the other. See, when God is talking, you got to be still and know that I am God. Boy, I wish I had somebody about it. We'll say amen. We are going, but we're not standing still to know that God is God. And sometimes God will say, stand still and see my salvation. See, the word tells us in his word. He said, once you stand still, he said, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. And you got to be in God's presence. And sometimes when the enemy says something about you, it just rolls off your shoulder. You say, Lord, I thank you. Because folks don't like you when you're anointed and you are appointed by God. See, everybody say they're anointed. They're not anointed. But when you're truly anointed by God, you're going to have some hell. You're going to have some haters. You're going to have some backbiters. You're going to have some lies. Why? Because you were anointed by God. And one thing when you were anointed by God, there's going to be some days you think you're all by yourself. There's going to be some days when you think nobody cares because you're standing on the word. See, when you stand on the word, all the hell and hell raises, they got to back up. When you stand on the word, the adultery folks got to get in the back. But when you stand on the word, the lying folks got to tremble. When you stand on the word, all things work together for the good that the Lord set up. Be careful in God's presence that the word you say, the word proceeded out your mouth, what you should be saying, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue to be in my mouth. That's the word you will say. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God. And you should go on and say, let not your heart be troubled. You have to put the word in, because the devil don't like it when they get together. The devil don't like it when you have a prayer meeting. The devil don't like it. In the name of the Lord, I come to tell you, I'm a hold on to what I know, and this I know. He didn't bring me this far to leave me. I'm going to stand on his word. I'm in his presence. Take me in your arms, Lord. Take me, Lord. Shake me. Rock me. Mold me in the way that you want me to be, Lord. Careful of the word you say in his presence, because the Lord hears everything. He knows your heart. Say amen.
Yes, Lord.
You ain't got to keep asking the Lord the same question over and over.
No, sir.
Lord, when you going to do it, stop asking him the same question over and over. He already done the first time when you asked him. Say amen. Say amen. Say amen. Amen. You ain't got to pray the same prayer over, brother. God, when you gonna send me a wife? Say amen. Amen. Anybody that come in ministry now to preach, you gotta be well equipped.
That's right.
Say amen. Say amen.
Yes, Lord.
Say amen. Say amen. And you gotta be able to have some patience.
Yeah.
Because you gotta have patience when you be married to a preacher. Say amen. Say amen. Then if you become pastor wife, amen, they gonna drive you crazy. Hello, somebody. Amen. You're going to wish you had a lot of dark and lovely, because your hair going to get gray real fast. Hello, somebody. Say amen. Amen. People can put things on you. We better make sure you know that God has something for you to do. Oh, I wish I had somebody. Say amen. 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 Folks always tell me, so, Pastor, no, you can't do that. No, Pastor, you don't get to do that. Oh, the prophet says so. Well, what the prophet are you talking about? I just know my own calling and my own spirit on the inside. You ain't got to tell me what the prophet said. I know what God is saying to me. Lord, I wish I had somebody. Amen. When the prophet is gone, I still have to rely on God. Lord, I wish I had somebody. I ain't talking about nobody. I'm just saying. Amen. Amen. So y'all don't take it in the wrong way. Amen. Because some of you, amen, got a prophet spirit instead of getting a God spirit. Amen. Because when the prophet is not around, when the apostle is not around, when the bishop is around, you still gonna have to go and talk to the Lord. Say, Lord, search me. It's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. Lord, I wish I had somebody. Say amen. 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 And amen. They told my first lady that when she, when I met her, amen. So you're gonna be an old maid before you get married. Amen. Amen. But when she got married, she was back and told her, I'm not an old maid. I got a husband now. Lord, I wish I had someone. All you gotta do is wait. Amen. You want your husband to be 6'2", good and look and handsome. You better thank God if he's ugly. Amen. You better appreciate the ugliness and try to work with him. Lord, I wish I had somebody. But you got to be careful in God's presence what you say. Because God see you move. He see your footstep. You say, all of my steps in the word. He know exactly where you're going when you leave here. I'm waiting, but Lord, you know, I'm still not content yet. Amen. I still can talk to somebody. If God going to give you somebody holy and sanctified, you got to put yourself on the side so when he comes, you can know that God said to you. Amen. You can't be running from Joe, Sam, and Fred. Lord, I wish I had somebody, a holy body, Lord. I wish I beseech you, brother, by the mercy of God, that you present yourself a living sacrifice. Holy. Lord, I wish I had somebody would say amen. I wish I had somebody would talk back to me. Lord, I wish I had somebody would say amen. I ran to so many preachers. I heard so many preachers, what you gonna do? You gonna get married again? I said, yeah, what, why you ask me that question? He said, I can't see you get married again. I said, well then shut up. You can't see, just shut up, because I'm not thinking like that. I just want to do the will of the Lord. I just want to do what God called me to do. You ain't got to remind me of nothing. I know what God told me. You can find out what God told me, but I'm not going to tell you. Lord, I wish I had somebody. For God I live and for God I die. In the name of the Lord. And I don't know about you. The Bible says you got to be contented that the state that you in. In the name of the Lord. Yes, you're going to have a lonely bird. Next, you're going to feel like nobody cares. But you got to look to the hills from which coming your help. And your help coming from the Lord. I wish I had somebody in the church would say amen. And we as preachers, we got to learn to get along with one another in the name of the Lord. We trying to pull one another down. Let us build one another and pray for one another in the name of the Lord. I wish I had somebody would say amen. All you praying for, you don't shut your prayer life down. You don't pray like you used to. Some of you got up this morning, thank you, Jesus. You didn't read the Bible. You came right to church. And after the first time you pick it up, some of you didn't get on your knees this morning. Got right out of bed. And got dressed and give God a praise. This is, Lord, I thank you for waking me up this morning. Lord, I wish I had somebody. You better thank God for the 6 o'clock prayer. Because we didn't have a 6 o'clock prayer, some of you still be in bed. Snoring and hanging up. But I thank God. How many know that prayer would change that? Look at your neighbors and neighbor. You better be careful what you say in God's presence. Because he hears every word you say. You know, I'm pastor. He don't understand me. I ain't supposed to understand you. God is the one that can understand you. He's the one that can mold and make you. In the way that he wants you to be. It's my job to lead you to Christ. Lord, I wish I had somebody. If you don't want to go, don't bother me. If you don't want to go, like I say, don't hinder me. Let me go and do what the Lord called me to do. Because time is drawing now. And it's getting late in the evening. And the sun is going down.
Yes, Lord.
Say amen. And some of you, Brother Rita, COVID-19 is an eye open to the body of Christ. I know some of y'all won't believe me, but it's an eye open to the body of Christ. And it's an eye open to the preachers too. To stop sugarcoating the word. Amen. You can find more church folks go to preachers that sugarcoat the word. Amen. Than the ones that really preach the word. Amen. Say amen. And then when you get in trouble, amen, they can't cast the devil out. You first think, I want to go back to my church so I can get just delivered. Amen. And sometimes you're not going to deliver as soon as you come back. Because God knows exactly what you're going to do. Hello, somebody. Amen. You go right back into the world. Amen. Some of your feet slipped last night before you came to church. And your fan didn't say amen. You done put one of them 45, your favorite song. One of them old melodies. When you say this song, keep me charged up before I get to church. But the only thing I know to keep me charged up is the word of God. Because the Bible says in the word of God, I have a hiding place. See, when you get in the word will charge you, energize you, wake you up, shake you when you get in the word. See, you know, if you get out in the word, you're going to feel defeated. But once you know the word, the enemy got to back up and say, he's anointed. Because you got the word. See, once you get the word in your heart, you can quote scripture from Genesis and Revelation. See, you don't have to have a scripture when you get ready to go preach. The preacher can say, I want you to preach here. Amen. You know, you prophesied, yeah, I want you to say a verse. You got the word already in your heart. You don't have to find your subject. Amen. Hey, anybody can find their subject. Amen. But once you got the word in your heart, you should always carry a state sermon in your heart. But you don't know when you're going to use. Well, I got to go seek the Lord. There's nothing wrong with that. But you should always carry a sermon. He said, that word have I hid in thy heart that you might not sin against thee. You should always have a word in your heart. To let the devil know, you're not going to stop me. I might have a little pain every now and then. But you're not going to stop me. Say amen. I'm getting to the point. I'm just sick of how he sings talking about. Say amen. Amen. But COVID-19, they act like they're afraid of the devil. Say amen. You ought to be talking net positive stuff.
That's it.
Say amen. Say, God has given us authority over this. Amen. He said, no weapon for me. But pastor is real. Yeah, I know he's real. Say amen. You got the people in the world talking more faith than some of these saints. Some of these people in the world that walk by the church talk more faith than you and Daniel. Some of these people encourage us to be sitting out there in front of the church. And it was wrong when they closed the church. I don't think they did that. That was wrong. And these are people not in the church. Amen. Church, okay, I need a break from everybody. Amen, because I need some rest. Ain't nobody taking me running, hoping and hopping and jumping all over the place. If you want some rest, you get some rest. Lord, I wish I had somebody, because you don't know what's going on. You don't know who to hug now, in the name of the Lord. Amen. They got us so distant. Amen. If we don't be careful, we're going to be doing like this. Amen. When they come to church, praise the Lord, stay over there. Praise the Lord, stay over there. Praise the Lord, stay over there. Amen. That's what the enemy wants, and that's what the world wants to see. Amen. We distant ourselves, but how long is this going to last? I don't know, but who knows how long it's going to last? His name is Jesus. The lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. He knows exactly how it's going to last. I wish I had somebody talk back to me. And I said on last Sunday, and if the people repent and sincerely repent and come back to God and pray, then God will turn some of these things around. Why? Because we are not praying like the Lord wanted to be praying. Amen. Then the Lord will move. You cannot move when you're not praying like you should. Hello, somebody say amen. Say amen. 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 That's why you get the pastor of the vision of the prayer conference. The reason the prayer conference is to bring you together into unity. Amen. Oh, I'm going to tap into your vision right now. It's the reason of the prayer conference so we can get vision and come into the midst of one another and pray one for another so the church can get strength. So when we get back to church, we should be on fire. Oh, we're not hearing somebody. But when we got back there and said, some of we were on fire, we worried about being isolated. Lord, I wish I had somebody else. I'm not worried about being isolated, because he told me in his word, if I walk up right, no good thing with the Lord will hold something. He said, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Lord, I feel my preaching mood coming on now. He said, women may endure for a night, but joy comes in the moment. Oh, Lord. I was weary, rude, and sad, but he picked me up and turned me around and put my feet on solid ground. Yeah, but I come to tell you that I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. When the devil get on your track, I heard a preacher say, when the devil get on your track, this one of the things one of my evangelists said, oh, get out of here. I come to tell the devil, get out of here, because you don't belong there. You don't have no charge over me. I'm serving a true and living God. He's Alpha and Omega. He's the beginning and the end. Lord, I wish I had somebody to say amen. But I don't know what you come to do. I came to pray the Lord. You know something? The prayer at 6 o'clock in the morning had revived me, had shaken me up, and God has shown me some things about some people. They're in the ministry, but they're not with you. Lord, I wish I had somebody that said amen, but yet they got a dagger in your back. Lord, I wish I had somebody they talk back to me. To all you haters, you better back up, because I'm going to walk down your alley. Lord, I wish I had somebody they talk back to me. But this is your prophecy. Let that man go. It's not your husband. Let that wife go. It's not your wife. And get in the road. And study the word. In the name of the Lord. Some of you don't like holding it. But I come to tell you, long as I'm saved and sanctified, they're going to be holiness or it's going to be hell. I'm going to stand on the word. And this is one thing I know. If I stand on his word, he's got to bless me. If I stand on his word, he's got to shake the devil. If I stand on his word, he's got to mold me. If I stand on the word, I got to get this into Revelation. I got to stand on his word. I got to stand flat footed and let the devil know. I'm not going to take down. I'm not going to leave. I'm going to hold on to what I know. And what you do know, my soul will look back and wonder how I got over 1976, the Lord brought me through. He's a wonder in my soul. See ya! Say yeah. Be careful of the words you say in God's presence. Because he hears every word you say. Maybe someone out in there in radio television land that don't know Jesus as the problem of your sin. Where you sitting there, where you driving your car, you listen to me. I want you to be sincere. Man look at outer appearance, but God look at the heart. And I want you to repeat these words after me. Say, Lord Jesus, forgive me for my sin. I believe you died for my sins. And I serve you the balance of my life. In Jesus' name, I pray. Right where you are, you're saved in faith and believing. But find you a church where this Bible is being preached. So you can know what the preacher is saying. Find you a church where the preacher is concerned about your soul. Not their pocket.
In
the
name
of the Lord. Amen. Amen. We got too many preachers pumping off the gospel.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody. Amen. And folks out there dying don't know Jesus. Amen. We have a work to do. Amen. God didn't spare our lives for nothing.
Amen.
He spared our lives for a reason.
Yes.
Amen. You could have been in one of those people with COVID-19, but God kept you behind. Because there's got a work to be done. Folks out here dying. Yes. Amen. Pastor Ari's son was 39 years old.